These scenes aren't from a movie. They weren't filmed on location. There were no actors, no costumes, no crew. And yet, here they are. A Roman soldier standing in the ashes of a collapsing empire. A World War I trench soaked in mud and silence. A medieval knight staring down his executioner. Each one created from a single prompt. Each one powered by artificial intelligence. This is the future of storytelling. And this is how a faceless history channel brought the past back to life, using nothing but a voice, a script, and a sentence. So let's start. It begins with one decision, the point of view. Not just picking a time period, but a moment, one heart caught in history. So I opened ChatGPT and asked for 5 emotional cinematic POVs from across time. This is what came back. A young nurse on D-Day pulling wounded soldiers from the surf. A black teenager listening to Dr. King's I Have a Dream speech. A Japanese citizen seeing the sky light up over Hiroshima. A German teen sprinting across the Berlin Wall the night it falls. A native child on the trail of tears holding their mother's hand. Each one a fragment of history. Each one already a story. I didn't need plot, I just needed presence. And one in particular stayed with me. The voice is where everything starts to feel real. I took the Hiroshima POV from earlier and asked ChatGPT to turn it into a first-person monologue. Not a speech, not a history lesson, just a memory, fractured and raw. This is what came back. The sky lit up like a second sun. I reached for my brother's hand, but there was only air, then fire, then silence. People moved like paper ghosts. I walked barefoot through what used to be our street, bleeding, but too numb to feel it. They said I survived, but I think part of me stayed in that flash. Short, quiet, under 100 words. You don't explain moments like this. You feel them. No names, no dates, just presence. And when I heard it aloud for the first time, that's when everything changed. Now it needed a voice. I opened ElevenLabs, the tool that turns words into something human. I pasted the Hiroshima monologue, selected a voice that felt soft and haunted, and slowed it down. No music, no effects, just breath and memory. It didn't sound like a voiceover. It sounded like someone trying not to cry. That's what makes the difference. Not just the voice you pick, but how it feels in silence. ElevenLabs lets you shape that feeling. Add pauses. Let the pain sit for a second too long. Bring in age, tremble, wait. For this one, I wanted it to feel like the person was remembering against their will, like the flash was still burning behind their eyes. I played it back, and for the first time, the story felt alive. If you want to try it yourself, the ElevenLabs link is in the description and pinned comment. I took that monologue and split it into scenes. Then I asked ChatGPT to turn each moment into a full first-person text-to-video prompt for Google Veo 3. Scene by scene, frame by frame. No extra effects, just pure storytelling. ChatGPT gave me scenes from the moment before the flash to the streets after. From finding a burned shoe to walking among the living ghosts. Then I opened Google Veo and entered each one. It took time, but when the clips rendered, it felt like memory. And this part matters because Veo isn't just a prompt toy anymore. If you're on a Google AI Pro plan, you can try it right now. Generate HD footage, stylize, animate camera movement, all from the voice of a survivor. The link's in the description and the pinned comment. And hey, if you've made it this far into the video, it means you're serious about learning. So hit like and subscribe. I've got more tutorials coming that go even deeper. Once I had all the pieces, the voice, and the visuals, I brought it into CapCut. The goal wasn't fancy edits, it was silence, stillness. I aligned the voice exactly to the pacing of the shots, faded in and out slowly, let each image breathe, no sound design except maybe the wind or the whisper of fire, just enough to keep it alive. And in the end, here are the results.
The sky lit up like a second sun, then everything turned to shadow. I remember reaching for my brother's hand, but there was only air, then fire, then silence. The street was gone, the neighbors were gone. My mother's voice was somewhere I couldn't follow. People moved like paper ghosts, skin trailing behind them, eyes too quiet. I walked barefoot through the pieces of our home, each step cutting a little deeper, but I didn't feel it. I was already somewhere else, somewhere before the light, before the wind that stripped the world away. They said we survived, but I think part of me stayed in that flash.
This didn't take a studio. It didn't take actors or even a camera. It took a story, a memory, a single sentence. With ChatGPT, ElevenLabs, Google Veo 3, and CapCut, you can build something real, something human, all without showing your face. So if you want more tutorials like this, subscribe. If this helped you, like the video. And if you're ready to start, all the tools I used are linked below. I'll see you in the next one.